I made an interesting discovery while testing a signal blocker for key fobs, specifically smart key fobs. This flaw can actually do the exact opposite of what you bought the signal blocker or Faraday pouch to do, which is to protect your car from theft. I'll demonstrate the flaw in this video and hope that we learn a thing or two. Now let's get this. When you hold the door handle of a car with keyless or smart entry, the anti-theft system via an assigned radio frequency will check whether the key or a programmed key signature is within a predefined proximity limit, usually about 1 meter. And if so, the car unlocks. This same technique is used to allow the car to start at the push of a button. However, using this same feature, thieves can actually acquire key signatures using a signal booster and relay the signal to the car, fooling the vehicle into thinking that the key is within proximity. Car door unlocks, engine starts, and the car is stolen. One way around this is to get a signal blocker or a Faraday pouch. In essence, Faraday pouches can help prevent your car from being stolen, which is exactly what I did. I actually bought two. However, I discovered one flaw that renders one of these Faraday pouches useless. I actually discovered this flaw by accident, and thank God I did. Let me demonstrate. Here I have the two Faraday pouches that I bought. This one looks the more premium, has a carbon fiber feel. So let me start with it. This is the key to the car, and just to demonstrate, push the lock button, it locks. Push the unlock, it unlocks. And I'll then just lock the car. Now I put the key fob into the Faraday pouch and zip it up. I try to gain smart entry and it works as it's designed to. But if you follow this channel and you've seen me program keys, you'd know that I have a silicone sleeve, which I usually use. Now watch what happens when I put the key into the silicone sleeve before putting it into the Faraday pouch. Sleeved key goes into the Faraday pouch and I attempt to unlock the door. Car door unlocks, it doesn't work. How come? Let's leave the more premium box and go over to the second pouch. I lock the car again, put the sleeved key into the pouch, reach for the door handle. This time it doesn't unlock, showing that this Faraday pouch is working just as it's designed to. So apparently this only happens with some Faraday boxes or pouches. Not sure what's happening here and how silicone is able to interfere with the blocking capability of this Faraday box. But I thought to share this just in case you use a silicone sleeve with your key together with a Faraday pouch. You might just want to confirm that it works well while using a silicone sleeve. Also, if you have a car with smart entry and you don't have a Faraday pouch, consider getting one. You'll be making your vehicle more difficult to steal. Hope this has been helpful. Catch you on the next one. Peace.